In today's session, we're going to talk about Azure Arc with cooperation with Kubernetes and what you can do with that when it comes to GitOps flows. So to set the stage, Azure Arc is really about extending the Azure control plane. If you think about it, Azure Resource Manager is the operating system of Azure. And what we want to do with Azure Arc is to extend or stretch that Resource Manager control plane. So the way you want to think about Azure Arc is really about trying to bring all the resources and all the things that you have deployed outside of Azure and bring those into Azure and to be represented as first-class citizens. So if you look at the diagram that I have, you're going to start on the left, right, as the Azure customer that using all the tools that he's familiar with, the SDKs, the API, PowerShell, and the UI. And from there, he's going to go into Azure to enjoy all the rich manifest that we have when it comes to environments, automation, access and security, organization, et cetera, et cetera. From there, we're starting to look at what you have on premises and in other clouds. We want to bring those resources that you already have in your multi-cloud strategy and what you have on premises and bring those into Azure. And again, represent them as first-class citizens. The way we are doing this is by using Azure Arc. Azure Arc extends the Azure Resource Manager control plane to represent those resources as first-class citizens inside Azure. To be more focused, today we're going to talk about Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. Currently, we have three offerings when it comes to Azure Arc. We have Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, we have Azure Arc-enabled servers, and Azure Arc-enabled data services, and we have more coming announcing in this Ignite. When it comes to Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, it's all about taking all the Kubernetes clusters that you have deployed outside of Azure and connect those into Azure Arc. By doing so, you are starting the process of fleet management. You have all your clusters in a single pane of glass, and everything is in the portal, so you can start managing it. From there, you're going to show some configuration. You're going to apply those configuration as GitOps configuration, which is what we're going to demo in a second here. The third thing is about operations and monitor. What you want to do after you get all these clusters into Azure, you want to start managing those the same way as you are doing in other clouds or on-premises. So we are offering you the capability to connect those clusters into Azure Monitor for containers and start managing the pods and the containers inside those pods as the way you would have done in other clouds. And the fourth thing is about governance and security. What we want to do by you bringing all these clusters into Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes, we want to make sure that you have a way to keep a baseline for those clusters. We want to leverage Azure Policy, for example, to make sure that you are using trusted container registries or making sure that you have ingress controllers deployed on all of your clusters in a standardized baseline. We also want to make sure that you have role-based access capabilities that coming from Azure Active Directory applied on those clusters. So these are the four bullets that really highlighting the value prop of Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. Specifically today, what we're going to focus on and in the demo we're going to show is what you can do with Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes and a GitOps flow. We're going to start with four clusters. And as you can see, I have a GKE cluster deployed in Google. I have an Azure Kubernetes service on HCI, which is our new Azure flavor of Kubernetes deployment. And you can see more details later on in this presentation, how to get started, and also in other session as part of this Ignite. We also have Elastic Kubernetes Service, EKS, deployed on Amazon, and a Rancher K3S cluster deployed on top of VMware vSphere. From there, we have those clusters already connected to Azure Arc, right? Those clusters are now represented as first-class citizens inside Azure. We're going to apply GitOps configuration. We're going to have two configurations, one on the cluster level and another one on the namespace level. We're going to touch on that in a second here. The GitOps configuration are responsible for deploying the Flux operator and, in our case, also the Helm operator. The Flux operator and the Helm operator together will create a handshake with the Git repository. The Git repository is where you have your application and the cluster baseline, and this is acting as the source of truth for your application and configuration of the cluster. Now, once the Flux operator is starting to listen to the Git repository, it will go and deploy the application that is part of that Git repository. We're going to consider that application as version 1. This is the source of truth and the desired state for this application. Then we're going to make a change on that application. That change will initiate a flow. What will happen is that Flux will pick up the changes that are happening on the Git repository, and from there, it will go and perform a rolling update for that application. This will be the version 2 of the application in the new desired state. Let's move on to the demo, and let me show you what we have. So to start off the demo, we have a resource group deployed. In this resource group, we have multiple Kubernetes clusters. The first two clusters that we're seeing are AKS clusters. These are no different than the clusters that you are familiar with that you are deploying in Azure. The third cluster that we have is an AKS on HCI Kubernetes cluster that is actually presented as an Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes. Now, this is our new Kubernetes flavor that we are announcing in this Ignite, which I'm going to share more detail later on in this presentation. We also have three clusters that are deployed outside of Azure. The first cluster is an EKS cluster. This is a cluster deployed on AWS, and you can see that this is actually the cluster that we are using. The second cluster is Rancher K3S. This is a Rancher cluster, a single node cluster that is deployed on top of VMware vSphere. And you can see here in my vSphere client that I have the virtual machine that deployed with that Rancher cluster. And you can see here that this is actually the cluster that we are showing, which is deployed with version 1.18.6 of Kubernetes and the K3S operating system. And the last cluster, which is the one that we're going to use as part of this demo, is the Arc GKE demo. This is a GKE cluster deployed in Google Cloud Platform, and we're going to show a full GitOps flow on top of that cluster. And this is the cluster that we have. We're going to come back to that in a second. If I'll go to the GKE cluster, what you will notice is that this is actually the GKE cluster, right? And this is an Arc-enabled cluster. But I'm going to go here to the configuration, which is the midst of our demo. I have a couple of configurations already applied on that cluster. The first configuration is an Nginx configuration, and it's deployed on the cluster level. And the second configuration is the Allow Arc configuration, which is applied on the namespace level. What we're doing with the GitOps flow, we're going to target those configurations into a Git repository. That Git repository is holding a couple of Helm charts. We have one for Nginx because we need to expose the web application into the outside world with an external service. And we have the Allow Arc application. That application is the one that we're going to manipulate and show a live GitOps flow happening on the GKE cluster. I'll zoom in to the Nginx one, and you can see that these are the parameters that this configuration has. And you can see here that I have the Git repository that I'm using and the release. We're going to go back to that in a second. If I'll go to the Allow Arc configuration, you can see that we are targeting the same Git repository, but here we are also pointing to a different release of Helm, right? So this is the prod release. So why two configurations? You have the cluster configuration. This will represent applications that you want to get deployed on all of your clusters that are now projected as Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes clusters. A good example will be service meshes or ingress controllers, security applications. So you want them to be on all of your clusters. The namespace configuration represents your application. This is the actual application that you are deploying on a dedicated namespace on your cluster. The Git repository that we're going to use is the one that you're seeing right here. This is a simple Git repository holding a demo application that we created. This is the Allow Arc web application. It's a simple Node.js application. If I'll go to the code here, you will see that I have two Helm charts, one for the Allow Arc application and another one for the Nginx. But more importantly, we also have releases. And this is what the Helm operator that we mentioned is going to leverage as part of the GitOps flow. The one that I want to show you is, first of all, is the Nginx one. And you can see that this is just the YAML file representing the release. And you can see that the namespace for this one will be cluster management. I'll go back to the prod release, and this represents the Allow Arc application. And you can see that this will get deployed on the prod namespace. Also, you can see that I have one replica for this application and the message. So let's go ahead and see what we have. I'll go back to the Kubernetes cluster deployed on GCP, and let's see what we have here in terms of services. We have a service here that was deployed as part of the Nginx deployment that went through the configuration of the GitOps that we applied on that cluster. let's go ahead and select that external service. And to show this demo, I really want to show it in three screens because we are showing a rolling update, right? So it's better to show that side by side. And here's the application, right? We already deployed that, it's already configured. And I have this small extension right here that will go and refresh the page every 2 seconds because we want to show the update in real time. I'm also going to go and show the pods that we have on the cluster management. The cluster management is the one that holding the Nginx deployments and the pods of it, right? And also, now I will show you the pods that we have in the prod namespace. And I'm going to add the watch flag because we want to show how we are making an update on the application and how is that going to translate on the GKE cluster. So let's go ahead and do that. This is the same application that I showed you before. And I'm going to go here to the releases and into prod, and we'll make a change on that application. What I'm going to do, I'm going to change the number of replicas, and I'm also going to change the message. So today we have a low R GitOps demo. You can see that on the right. And for, let's edit for Ignite 2020. And I'm going to go ahead and commit those changes, which is equal to merge in production, right? So I'm going to go ahead and commit, and let's see what's happening on the left side. On the left side, you can see that the pods will start the rolling updates. The Flux operator is listening to that Git repository and capturing a change. And in a second, you will see on the right that the message is also changing to the one that we just did, right? A low arc GitOps demo for Ignite 2020. Also, it will deploy more replicas of that pods because we changed it from 1 to 3. So in a second, you will see the message starting to bounce, right? Because the load balancer, the Nginx that is deployed on that cluster is doing its thing. It's basically load balancing between the pods, right? So you can see on the left that here we already have the pods running. And in a second here, you're gonna see that the application is actually changing. There you go. Hello, our GitOps demo for Ignite 2020. So what is it that we did right now? We applied a new configuration on a Helm release, right? The Flux operator with the Helm operator captured those changes and updated the application in real time. So hopefully that demo showed you what is the capabilities that we have with Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes with GitOps configuration. So we showed you a demo on GitOps configuration with Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes, but how do you actually get started? We have a jumpstart repository that holds 30 plus examples, including the demo that I just showed on how to get started with Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes with a bunch of automation scenarios, bootstrap scenarios, day two scenarios. So please go ahead and visit that jumpstart repository. To get started with our new AKS on HCI offering, again, our own flavor of Kubernetes in Azure that we are announcing in this Ignite, go to the link that you see on the slide. And to know more about Azure Arc for servers, Kubernetes, data services, and the other Azure Arc offering that are coming, visit the third link that you see on the screen. Thank you, everyone. This has been a great way to show you what Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes with GitOps is all about, and hopefully you enjoyed the session and the demo. I hope you will have a great Ignite and stay safe, everyone.